Hello and welcome once again to yet another edition of the Red Groove Revolution. I'm your host, DJ Solero, and I have my special guest back in the house once again, DJ Dragon. Is it Dragon or DJ
Dragon?
Just simply Dragon,
yeah,
right?
Simply Dragon, baby.
Welcome back once again, man.
Right.
What's going on? What's been popping with you?
Just working, you know, doing a 9-to-5 bid. You know how that go.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Was digging, you know. Sorry to hear about James Brown passed away. Really touched my heart. I was like, oh, snap, James Brown died, and on Christmas Day.
Yeah, I know.
So I was like, what? And I had to just muscle up.
Some treats.
Yeah, muscle up some treats and let everybody know that, you know, James Brown is going to be living in our hearts forever. Every Christmas, make a moment for James Brown, because if it wasn't for him, you wouldn't have all of this, which is the urban music we got today. You know what I mean? And by the way, speaking of treats, I picked you up a little something courtesy of Harlem Underground.
You know what I mean? Are you serious?
Yeah, I got to show you some love since James Brown.
That's what's up, man.
That's what's up. Big shout out to Hal at Harlem Underground.
Good looking out, man.
No doubt. You know what I'm saying?
All right. So being that this is the James Brown Chronicles.
Yes.
As you titled
exactly, James Brown Chronicles. You know what I mean?
What you want to do? How you want to kick off this show?
Well, kick this off with the first joint right here by James Brown called Don't Tell It. James B, you know what I mean? It's just rocking. It's a hot joint. I hope you guys out there in Breakbeat Land will enjoy it.
Let's hear it.
One, two, get down.
That's what's up.
James Brown.
That was made popular by so many, well, a couple of hip-hop names come to mind, but, you know, that's one of the many examples of why James Brown is considered not only the godfather of soul, but pretty much the godfather of, like, hip-hop music.
Exactly.
Funk, you know, inspiration to many people in the music industry, spanning all genres of music.
Exactly. He spawned a lot, James Brown.
So what else we got in the stash, brother?
I know you got
a hell of a lot of James Brown.
James Brown.
Up in the mix
here. Hopefully
it
could stand up.
Yeah.
We got Getting Down to It.
Which he's definitely doing by this pose.
Yeah.
Looking at this pose.
is Getting Down
To It. Yeah, I just do it like
Getting
that.
Getting Down To It by James Brown. And the name of this cut was There Was A Time.
There Was A Time. Let's hear it. Now that was James Brown, or was it the D Felice
Trio, but James Brown produced it.
Oh, right.
So it was There Was A Time by James Brown and the D Felice Trio. But it's the fact that he produced it, anything that James Brown had on it, and look at the influence that this record had.
That's true.
As you know, the bass line is funky, sampled by those chosen few, you know what I mean, that really know what's up with James Brown.
Yeah, yeah. So big shout out to the late great Paul C, by the way.
Yeah, definitely. You know what I'm saying?
All right. Yes, sir. So what else we have here?
Okay. We got
some 45s up in the mix.
Yeah, 45 joint.
Oh boy.
Produced by James Brown, but it's the JB's.
Okay.
It's called Hot Pants Road.
Hot Pants Road. Let's hear it. Yeah, you got the 45. We'll be right back. True indeed. Hot Pants Road by the JBs.
The JBs, produced by James Brown on his People 45. Big shout out to Al Sharpton. Big shout out to James Brown and his immediate family and everybody. God bless him. Definitely.
Okay.
That's what's up right there, James right. Brown.
So what else you got here?
Well, the treat I got right here is another James Brown production, but it's his background singer or one of his singers, Marva Whitney, called Things Gotta Get Better.
Okay.
This is the 45.
Let's hear it.
Mm-hmm.